Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on job sequencing with deadlines problem in greedy method in design and analysis of algorithms. Before going to job sequencing with the deadlines problem, so greedy method is one of the algorithm design method. This method is mainly used for solving optimization problems. Optimization problem may require either maximum result or a minimum result. It depends on the given problems. Sometimes some problems may require maximum result. So at that time, that problems are called as maximization problems. Sometimes a problem may require minimum result. So at that time, these problems are called minimization problems. Okay. Next, we go for job sequencing with deadlines problem. So job sequencing with the deadlines problem can be stated as follows. Suppose there are n number of jobs are there. Each and every job has a particular deadline, D suffix I. Here, D suffix I is always greater than 0. If the job is executed on a single processor within the deadline, then we are getting the maximum profit, P suffix I. Okay, our main objective is to complete the execution of n jobs within their deadline. If the jobs are completed within their deadline, okay, that jobs are considered. Among the n number of jobs, which jobs are completed within their deadline? Which has the maximum profit? Okay, that jobs are considered as optimal solution. Okay, for example, so there are n is equal to 4 jobs. Okay, 4 jobs has the deadline 2, 3, 1, 2. Okay, the maximum deadline is 3. Here, we are processing 4 jobs. Among the 4 jobs, only we are considering 3 jobs which has the maximum profit that are executed within their deadline. That jobs are considered as the optimal solution for the given problem. The arrangement of jobs on a single processor within the deadline constraint is called as job sequencing with deadlines problem. In job sequencing with deadlines problem, only one processor is available for executing n jobs. Each and every job can take only one unit of time for execution on a single processor. So now this is the one example instance. For this example instance, we have to find out the optimal solution and also find out the maximum profit that we are obtaining. Okay, so for this one, the first step is arranging the profits in decreasing order. Okay. So among them, which job has the highest profit? That is P7. So that is equal to 30. Okay. Next one, 20 is P3. Next one, 18. That is P4. This is 18. Next one, 6. So P6. That is 6. Next one, P2. That is 5. Next one, P1. That is 3. Next one, P5. That is 1. So after arranging the profits in decreasing order, so these are the profits. Next, according to that, we are arranging the deadlines. Okay. So job 7 deadline is 2. Next one, job 3 deadline is 4. Next one, job 4 deadline is 3. Next one, job 6 deadline is 1. Next one, job 2 deadline is 3. Next one, job 1 deadline is 1. Next one, job 5. So job 5 deadline is 2. Okay. So after arranging the profits in decreasing order, according to that, we are also arranging the deadlines of 7 jobs. Here n is equal to 7. There are 7 jobs are there. Okay. Now consider among the deadlines of 7 jobs. Okay. Which is the maximum deadline? That is 4. Okay. Now we are arranging 4 jobs. Okay. So that is 4. This box has 4 cells. Okay. Among the deadlines of 7 jobs. Okay. What is the maximum deadline? That is 4. Okay. Now we are taking 4 cells. The first cell is 01. Second cell is 122. Third cell is 223. And fourth cell is 324. Okay. Next. This first one is output job set. Output job set. Second one is assigned slot. Assigned slot. Third one is selected job. Selected job. And fourth one is action. And fifth one is profit. Okay. First one is, first we are taking the maximum profitable jobs. Okay. Initially, output job set is 5. There is no solution initially. Assigned slot is also 5. Now, which job is selected first? So, among the 7 jobs, which job has the maximum profit? That is, job 7 has the maximum profit. That is P7, that is 30. First, we have to select maximum profitable job. That is job 7, its profit is 30. So job 7 is selected. Okay. What is the deadline of job 7? That is deadline 2. Okay. So this job 7 can be assigned to maximum deadline cell. Here 2 is nothing but, so here there are 2 units. First unit is 0 to 1 and second unit is 1 to 2. So this job 7 is completed either first one unit of time or second one unit of time. We are taking the maximum. Okay. So Maximum is second unit of time. So that is 1 to 2. So assigned to 1 comma 2. Okay. So here 0 comma 1 is the first unit of time. 1 comma 2 is the second unit of time. We are taking the maximum value. Maximum value is second unit of time. Second unit of time is 1 to 2 because its deadline is 2. What is the profit we are getting? That is profit is 30. Job 7 profit is 30. So okay, 1 to 2 we are assigning job 7. Okay, next. Output job set contains only one job, that is job 7. Assigned slot is 1 comma 2. Next, which job is selected next? Among them, 30 is completed. Among them, which is the maximum profit? That is 20 is the maximum profit. Okay, so 20 is job 3. So next, we have to select job 3. Okay, what is the deadline of job 3? That is 4. So this job 3 is completed within first unit of time or second unit of time or third unit of time or fourth unit of time. This job 3 is completed either in first unit of time, that is 0 comma 1, second unit of time 1 comma 2, third unit of time 2 comma 3, fourth unit of time 3 comma 4. Among the 4 units, we have to take the maximum unit of time. Maximum unit of time is 3 comma 4. Okay, so here this is job 3 that can be assigned to 3 comma 4 because its deadline is 4. What is the maximum profit? That is 20. Okay, so total 30 plus 20. So that is equal to 50. Okay. Sorry. This is 50. This is 20. Okay. Next. Here. J7 comma J3. So this job is union with the J7. Then we are getting J7 comma J3. Okay. What is the slot? So J7 slot is 1 comma 2 and J3 slot is 3 comma 4. Okay. Next, which job is selected? So this one is completed and this one is completed. Remaining 5 jobs, among the remaining 5 jobs, which job has the maximum profit? That is 18. 18 is a P4 job. So, P4 job has the next maximum profitable object, that is J4. P4 is nothing but J4. So, what is the deadline? Deadline is 3. So, this job 4 is completed its execution either first one unit of time or a second unit of time or a third unit of time. We are taking the maximum unit, that is 2 comma 3. 2 comma 3, we are assigned job 4. So assigned to So what is its profit? That is 18. 50 plus 18, that is 68. 50 plus 18, that is 68. This is the profit. Next. So this job 4 can be added to this solution J7 comma J3 after combining, after union, then we are getting the output job set, job 7, job 3, job 4. Okay, here we are arranging the slots in increasing order, that is 1, 2, 2, 3 and 3, 4. Okay, next, which job is selected? So of this job is completed, this job is completed, this job is completed. Next maximum profit is 6. Okay, so 6 is belongs to, that is job 6. Okay, so next we have to select job 6. What is the deadline of job 6? So its deadline is 1. Okay, this job 6 is completed within the first unit of time because its deadline is 1. Okay, so first unit, that is J6. Okay, so assigned to (0, 1), that is 68 is previous profit. 68 plus 6, that is 74. Here 68 plus 6, that is equal to 74. Okay, so next, after combining job 6 to the previous solution, that is J7, J3, J4, next one is J6. So after arranging the slots in increasing order, that is 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3 and 3, 4. Okay, next, which job is selected? Okay, next maximum profitable job is, next maximum profit is 5. 5 belongs to P2. P2 belongs to job 2. So job 2 has, what is the maximum profit? What is the deadline? 3. So this job 5, job 2, J2, next maximum profit is 5. 5 belongs to P2. P2 belongs to job 2. Its deadline is 3. So this job 2 is completed within first unit of time or second unit of time or a third unit of time. Okay, third unit is 2, 2, 3. It is not vacant. So next, job 2 is completed within second unit of time, that is 1, 2. It is not vacant. Okay, next, job 2 may be completed within first unit of time, that is 0, 1. It is not vacant. Okay, so there is no vacant for completing the job 2 with the deadline 3. First unit of time, that is 0, 1, not vacant. Second unit of time, 1, 2, it is not vacant. Third unit of time, 2, 3, it is not vacant. So that is job 2 is rejected. Rejected, maximum profit is 74. Okay, so same, this is the same solution. J7, J3, J4, J6. This is same 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3 and 3, 4. Next, what is the maximum profitable, maximum profit? That is 3. 3 belongs to P1. P1 belongs to J1. What is its deadline? Its deadline is 1. So that is job 1. Okay, job 1 has a deadline 1. It should be completed first one unit of time. First one unit of time is 0, 1. It is not vacant. So that this job is also rejected. Profit is also 74. Okay, next one is job 7, job 3, job 4, job 6. This is also same, no change, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4. Next. What is the maximum profit job? That is 1. 1 belongs to P5. P5 belongs to job 5. Okay. Job 5 has the deadline 2. So that is J5 has the deadline 2. So this J5 job may complete its execution within first unit of time. That is 0, 1. It is not vacant. Second unit of time, that is 1, 2. 1, 2, it is not vacant. So there is no possibility of execution of J5 with the deadline 2. So that it is rejected. So maximum profit is 74. Okay. So here the 7 jobs are completed. Okay. Among the 7 jobs, only 4 jobs has the maximum profit that are completed within their deadline on a single processor. So therefore, the optimal solution is, the optimal solution is, so this one is J6. J6, J7, J4, J3. J3 with maximum profit. With maximum profit 74. So maximum profit is 74, and job sequencing is, first job 6 is completed within their deadline 1. Next job 7 is completed within their deadline, so 2. Next job 4 is completed within their deadline 3. Next job 3 is completed within their deadline 4. Okay. Here 7 jobs are completed within their deadline, but among the 7 jobs, only 4 jobs that has the maximum profit that are completed within their deadline. So only these 4 jobs are considered. Okay, so the optimal solution is J7, J6, J7, J4, J3 according to the slot wise. Okay, with the maximum profit is 74. Okay, so this is the job sequencing with the deadlines problem. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel DIVVELA SRINIVASA RAO. DIVVELA SRINIVASA RAO. Thank you.